Hey there, art weirdos. Wanted to give you a little peek what I'm working on right now. This voiceover is not going to go for too long, mostly because I don't like the sound of my own voice and I don't want to have to hear it while I'm editing this video. But what I've got for you right now is a piece, currently a painting, probably also a print eventually. The prompt was fish. So I started researching very Twilight Art, the creative habit style, which you should read if you haven't read it already, with a lot of the mythology of fish. I kind of started with Dylan because I have a child named that who was a Welsh god that upon being baptized became one with the sea. Mermaids also were an obvious. There was a lot of sketches of mermaids. This is a sketch of mermaids, but we'll get back to how we came full circle to mermaids. Lots of mermaids. I kind of branched into water nymphs. I thought of sirens, but it turns out they weren't actually fish people originally. They were bird people, and had to do with mourning in ancient Greece. And that's a really intriguing topic that I think I'm going to be exploring more in my sketchbook and maybe on a finished piece. So after lots and lots of exhaustive research, and, you know, because The Witcher, I was reminded that Rusalka are a thing. And I started reading up on a lot of the mythology behind Rusalka. When I told a friend about it, she actually sent me the Dvořák opera, Rusalka. So when I think about women who have become sometimes vindictive water spirit ghosts because they drowned themselves, I thought immediately of Ophelia from Hamlet. Because that's how my brain works. So I started looking at other pictures of Ophelia. Of course, John Everett Millais' Ophelia is pretty much like the painting. But I also came across Alexandra Cabanel's Ophelia. And there's something about it that's a little bit more... I don't know, her pose is a little more seductive. I think, you know, she's very like, oh, the branch broke. Here I am, laying in the water. You know, she's not exactly quite drowned. She's a little seductive. She's a little bit more Rusalka, in my opinion, than your average Ophelia drowned in the lake after the willow branch, quote unquote, broke depiction. So while listening to the opera Rusalka, thinking about Ophelia, I went more into the plot of Dvořák's Rusalka, and wouldn't you know, Rusalka is based more on The Little Mermaid than on Rusalka legends. And that is how we have come back to mermaids. So we have, because Rusalka, I'm sorry, I should clarify if you don't know, Rusalka of Russian, Ukrainian, Czech legend, are not mermaids. They have legs, they walk around, they actually like to climb trees and dance, sometimes to try to drown people, sometimes just because they have a song in their heart, I guess. So, but my Rusalka, my Ophelia Rusalka of Dvorak's Rusalka does have a tail fin. She is still fallen out of a willow tree. Don't ask me how she climbed up the willow tree with that tail. I don't know everything. That hand reaching up into the air gives me so much trouble. You're going to see, I'm going to save it to like the very, it's going to be the very last thing I do. And spoiler alert, it still looks pretty fucked up. But just a little bit, I'm just inking right now. I previously sketched out, so Alexandra Cabanel's Ophelia, I have so appropriated. The pose is his. The willow tree's broken branch is from that painting. It's flipped, by the way, just because for compositionally, I don't know. I feel I like things more on the right, I guess. I just thought it, my version looked better that way with the tail and the curve of the willow tree. So I've got, it's the same pose, it's the same hair. The fishtail is from a stock image that I will link in the description. The willow tree is Cabanel's willow tree, but when I get to painting it, the actual willow tree I'm referencing is another stock image that I will also link. And then the background is actually from some of my own swamp photos that I've taken myself. So it's a little weird manda twist on a very highly academic portrait painter from the 1800s who definitely would have hated my work and probably would have not admitted me to the salon, you know, other than because of my genitals. So I'm going to let you finish watching this in peace and not have to listen to me babble on any longer. You're listening to Dvorak's Rusalka in the background, so enjoy watching me draw Rusalka while listening to Rusalka.
Thank you. скахавет, ктерат збркле пади, порем, 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 инум лади, лади.
So pretty much there you have it. This is the end of the part one, the drawing phase of my Ophelia as Rusalka. I haven't inked everything. I've been into this more illustratively heavy contour line drawing style again lately, art style in general, finished piece. I think it comes from being a lithographer. But I'm not inking everything in this painting. The background, for reasons of composition and contrast and perspective, is going to be much more painterly. Might ink some of the foreground willow vines. We'll find out next time. The next video will be part two, which will be the painting portion of this as soon as I finish it up. So I'm going to get off my recorder, get off my computer, and get to work. Thanks for joining me. I will see you later. Bye.